Candles by Nan MacDonald.
100 years ago, the sun-struck sails of a ship moved in the rolling plains of sea on the great voyage out to New South Wales. It was fair weather, white and gold and blue. On deck, the settlers drowsed in the long trough of peace between the old life and the new. Suddenly, fear jarred taut the sliding days, for a child hurt his eyes, the shade deep brown that still looked with a baby's solemn gaze. These must be trusted, being so far from land, to the ship's surgeon, frock coat derelict, slurred learning, strong breath and uncertain hand. Nothing to do but pray that hand should find, by the mercy of God, some memory of its skill, and the hand fumbled, and the child was blind. Deep undersea, the currents move and swing. One ship out from the convoy, and she goes south and yet south over the icy ring into dark silences, where not again the warm sun will rise up to blaze her course to the mast's thick harbour and the tongues of men. He was too young to know he was alone. This weary night was no more strange to him than the world of salt-scrubbed planks and bright spray blown, harsh ropes his small, fat hands would pat, the play of gleaming, following wings, and he sat still, so patient now. But sometimes he would say, "Will they light the candles when we come to Sydney?" This she was called to endure, who would have done anything else, who would most willingly have burnt her own eyes out to light her son. And when they came to Sydney, glided clean through the heads on a blue day, saw shining sky arched over jeweled bays, and the hills between, each sunshaft in green depths was a turned blade, and each thin, shimmering leaf on land, a spear in the open wound his echoing question made. Asking of all this brilliance, but the dim halo around a pointed yellow flame, and this she could not even promise him. That is a story. No one, listening, hears more of that ship, of crew or passengers. The roaring waters of 100 years have drowned all but the little voice that yet floats on, slipping from wave to wave, because no woman hearing it could quite forget.
The reader was Judy Morris. Douglas Stewart's The Silkworms, the reader John Millian.